everyone. You are not confused. You're definitely still watching Hashtag Trending right here on Bumagaba Channel 260 on your favorite channel, by the way. Do not change the dial because namhlanje we'll be having a candid conversation with my best friend, uAndile Wakwalanga. We'll be discussing everything from boyfriends, girlfriends, yonke into eyenziwayo apha emhlabeni. Also, a little bit more about ifamily yakhe nentsukaphi. And but the most important thing, we'll be talking about umnanaye. My name is Just Solomon, and you are watching your favorite Ndithathile ke Indawo, because this is a takeover. Izabe isenziwa ndimu. Do not change the dial. So namhlanje we are sitting with uAndile Kit Langa. A lot of people actually mhlambi ke abayazi ba he calls himself Kit. He got that name from enye ex yakhe engafuna ukuthetha ngayo. But he's joining us namhlanje as we'll be having a beautiful conversation. A tell all ngam naye. UAndile, how are you doing?
I'm good, my love and gentlemen.
I am not good. I am taking your seat namhlanje. Get to interview you.
Weird. Because usually I'm on that seat. But if it's you, then it's fine.
Kind of very good. Very demure, is it not?
Oh, very classy.
Very cute.
Very okay, mindful.
I've known you from the days of Ezamukukanye. A lot of people don't know that, right? Yeah. We've known each other for a very long time.
It has.
Tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, before ndiye apho, chimicola kamnandi mostly. Please, let's get that out there.
I bo.
Okay. So, if just know, Beyonce, ufunda, kum. And that's where I go everywhere.
Yeah.
So, those days, before we even met, hey, dandi umdana gengela kwesha, before I met you, but as I used to be so innocent, and I used to sing a lot, you know, diambe, certainly di kula. And then, I remember when I met you, it literally changed my entire life. And it's one of the things that I'm grateful for, because it's been over a decade since we've been friends, and it's been a fun ride. So I think for that, thank you very, very much.
It definitely has been. I remember a time when we went to your house.
Yeah.
And your mom's speciality was ukusenzela amagwinya with mince inside. And ubuthanda kunvimba. Why? Why
vimba? So I have a rule, right? Ubuthanda bamigaqini chomi. Akubona? So, Dandy has bamnanza abana makunya amai 2. And then everybody's going to have makunya amai 2. And then I used to think, uzawutya ukutya kwam, akhoke agoduke ayotya kwabo. Ayotya kwabo. So it wasn't because Dandy vimba. But it also then zama ukufundisa indeni nokuba abana masifike phango 3 xa sivisitor singafike phango 6
teacher
xa kusondele ixesha ukubona. But xa mna ndiyenza kowenu, I'm very grateful that nani ndiphakela wethu ndibene plate yam.
My mom's teachings. What I want to ask this one question.
Yeah.
What has been the most fondest memory of our friendship, pakati mnanawe, outside of the fact that tisaro joga ninsi mnanawe, but what has been that one fondest memory of this friendship? Because I can definitely tell you, Umna, but what is your fondest memory of this friendship?
Knowing that you're always there for me when I need you, and knowing that you will always put me in the lane, you know, because if there's one thing that I am, it is impulsive, right? Especially when it comes to romantic relationships, I get easily excited. But every time when I come to you and be like, show me, and you're like, breathe. Paula,
yeah,
you know? And also when it comes to like decisions about my career, decisions about family, decisions about things that I want to, you know, buy and change in my life and in my career, you're always there and you're like, okay, breathe, chill, speak to me. And no, maybe don't do it this way, do it that way. So I think also that thing of knowing that you're always there for me, that for me is like the greatest thing ever. Sometimes but yeah, definitely.
We're going to be diving deep into Leo Kakulu and talking about love, talking about relationships and everything.
Yeah.
But I think just for me, the one thing is, the one thing that I love is also you being present. you know, in my being single, but you've always tried to bring people into my life, ending up with you. You know, I want us to get a little bit on Ulinduka Ukcula. Ukcula kwakho kuqale phi and what was the love of singing? Because I met you through Andile B.
Yeah.
Actually, that's how I met you. Mm-hmm. Just quickly, a little bit, now, slow down.
So Ukcula has always been, you know, part of my thing. Yeah. My mom and my dad, badibana ekwayareni back in the day. My dad was singing in a choir and my mom was singing in a choir. So I think ndapakanyelwa by both of them. So that is where my love for music and my love for singing came from. But most importantly, yaqala unyuka, you know, uqala kwamukhonza, you know, uqa wayo sindiso, ndabona mic, ndabona keyboard, I was like Beyonce. You know, because in mics then this genre that is close when I could use videos got Beyonce. So I was like, I am going Zandin Kling about Andile B chomi, okay, that comba to some who Beyonce.
Ekaweni
chomi. Dafika, Danika mic, Dago Prison worship, that girl is solo, that teen. I was like, this is where I'm supposed to be. You know, demure. Mindful, because I'm the Beyonce in the church. So I think, yeah, I think that's where it started.
So I'm going to mention an artist.
Okay.
And then you're going to mention a song.
Okay.
And I'm taking it to Ukulula Gwako.
Okay.
Marvin Sepp. Take it back to church. Take it back to the choir. Marvin Sepp.
I'm on my way. Don't make me sing.
Yes.
Because now people are going to find just out a little
bit. Just a little bit.
Because that's the takes the vocals from me.
But that's the song I knew you ngayo.
I've had my share of ups and downs. Mm-hmm. Times when there was... No, and when I sang that song, right, funny thing, I was forced to sing it. Right?
And you cried.
I cried because I didn't want to sing it. But also I didn't want to sing it because... It means a great deal for me,
yeah.
You know, because having, you know, grown up with one, I'm a homosexual, you know, two, not everybody understood that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
So that song for me was very personal, you know, in the sense of having my ups and downs with homophobia, with people calling me names and all of that. So when they asked me to sing that song, I was like... the song is too deeper
it
than that.
Deep,
so I think that's why I cried.
Mm.
So that I think that's also why that song by Marvin Sepp is one of my favorites.
But also I believe in Ndok Bananga, but the Beyonce came out. That's why you cried.
Even Vai told me. No, but like also that was my biggest song.
Yes, that's the song Wazuwangayo, by the way.
Basically. So that was my debut.
You are going to give us a little bit of Langoma Mas, right?
Yeah.
Pamkoba Sikribe Yonkin.
And so, sometime, sometime, check my YouTube channel. The song is there. No,
okay.
Do you want me to do it now?
No. What we are going to do is definitely get to know Andile more and more, Sazi. A little bit about umama wake, no tata wake, no brother wake. Like Hitswele, we are going to remove every part of it up until Sazi Ilenduka, the core of Andile ba. Usuka pilom dulona, waziwa ngobani, utandane nobani, because I definitely know ba. Niyafuna ukwazi bangibani ex yakhe. Ayindim phofu. Ayindim. You're still watching Hashtag Trending right here on Channel 260. Mpuma Kapa, your channel of choice. Don't change the dial because kusezo bamnandi mchana. This is The Takeover. To your favorite show, Hashtag Trending, right here on Mpuma Kapa TV. We're still having a tell-all with Andile Wakalanga, as we are going to be diving more and more. Okwangoko, it's going to be very deep. It's going to be very personal. Andile, are you ready for this one? Or you want to take a sip?
Please.
Because we are diving deep.
Please.
We are definitely diving deep. All right. Mm. Okay. Now, earlier you mentioned something very... very touching, you know, when we were speaking about the Marvin Sepp song.
Yeah.
And you spoke about you being a homosexual.
Yeah.
Right? I think the best way is to say you being queer.
Let's use that.
Yeah, because it sounds very offensive.
Oh, okay.
You know?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You being queer.
Yeah.
Tell us, how did you navigate that with telling abazali bakho?
Yeah.
Of course, you know abazali, they know, you know, but how did you navigate your coming out to your parents?
I think they've always known.
Yeah.
That's one. But also, two, having that conversation with my dad, which made it to Drum Magazine, because I did a thread on Twitter. My mom, everything was okay. She already knew from Ukulakwam, because apparently Ukulakwam Dukule did very cute, like a girl.
True.
You know, then my brothers are Mandomazana because they were expecting a girl. They didn't do a scan because it was that long back in the day. I'm not telling you my age, but do the math. So they were expecting a girl. So I think Nembahle Bazithengayo were girls' clothes until Ndafika, and they were like, oh, it's a boy. But like, nobody cares. Because you don't know anything. And then, as far as my dad is concerned, I remember I had that conversation, and he asked me, you know, so when you get married, are you going to get married to a guy or to a girl?
Mm.
And I was like, what?
Very question.
You understand?
Yeah.
And we had that conversation where he told me how proud he is of me and how much he loves me, whomever I choose to love or whomever I choose to marry. So coming from that type of family where you were accepted and you are loved irregardless, that for me was the biggest thing, even despite everything else that happened. You know,
I want us to actually dive into that one, because now we've known each other for a very long time.
Yeah.
And I've been there through everything.
True.
The turning point. You know, you're a church now, and things come out.
Yeah.
You come from a church up where they had beloveds.
Yes.
Right. And you had a beloved, if I could remember.
Very
right.
Well.
So for those of you who don't know, a beloved is a girlfriend, but in the church context, right? You have a beloved.
Yeah.
They find out about you.
Yeah.
And how was that?
So, you know how it is in Gonzeni, you get to the age where, you know, now they kind of like train you up to be a husband, right? And I figured they knew before that, but like, sometimes girls are Cindy, so they can be very rigid, you know? So I was paired up with this girl. I don't want to say her name because, you know, but for
Poppy Act, Poppy Act, please.
We'll just call her Asanda.
Yeah.
So I got paired up with Asanda. Asanda knew everything about me, because Asanda was my friend before we got paired up, right? So she knew everything about me. She knew I was queer. She knew I dated boys. She knew that I was dating a boy in the church. But, you know, everything was just cool, right? Until everything got so serious. Now we are going to meetings. Now we are going to training. Now we are going, you know, we're actually being trained. And then everything just...
Do you think the church was oblivious to who you were?
I think they wanted me to change.
Yeah.
And they really had hope that I was going to change. You know, through the prayers, through the sessions, through the casting out of the demon of home, you know, of being queer. They thought, and being paired, you know, with a girl
was going to change everything.
Was going to change me, you know. But then I was like, guys, but if God wanted me to change to be changed, don't you think maybe he would have done something?
He would have
something?
Definitely intervened.
You understand? Mm. So I think that part of my life was them trying to say, much as we don't support your lifestyle, but we're going to change you and we're going to pair you up with, you know, a biological female. It didn't work because we ended up breaking up and, you know, because...
People were hurt.
But I'll never understand because
she
also
was... excited.
Yeah. She was also hurt. And I never understood, why are you hurt?
And he was excited.
Well, yeah, my boyfriend was excited that time because I was sharing, you know, basically I was sharing myself with him and with her. So when we broke up, it was like, yippee, now I have you back all to myself.
To myself.
Which is weird.
Now, so Ayonando, in that I want to get is this church, this home.
Yeah.
Home you're accepted, at church you are... Mm-hmm. You're being cut out.
Yeah.
Right. Of course, you were cut out even from the choir, from everything.
Everything, girl.
And from the church. So, what lesson have you learned from these two.
Yeah.
You see, it's like you are mirroring, and you are standing in front of a mirror now,
yeah.
and then you are looking, this is home and this is church.
Yeah.
What are you taking out of these two parts?
Always go to where you are loved and accepted. That's the biggest lesson that I've learned, because after everything happened with church, then dayeka, you know? And then I dahlala endlini, you know? And my mom kept telling me, we love you, we accept you, God loves you, God accepts you. And I was like, you know what? Everything that happened there, much as it has defined parts of me, but I'm not gonna let it be me. So I think more than anything, it's just go to the place where you are loved. That for me was the big take.
The biggest take.
Yeah.
If you were to say something to the then Andile,
yeah,
the queer Andile who was confused then,
yeah,
right now, what are some of the things that you've learned that you would like to teach him, or that you would have loved that Azazi then, so that he could become a stronger version then than now?
It would be, you are perfect the way you are.
Mm.
Of all the being tried and being changed, it taught me that I am perfect the way I am. I will make mistakes. I will, you know, I will have my ups and downs, but I am perfect the way I am. I love my mistakes. I love how I make my mistakes. I love how I learn from those mistakes. And I am perfect in that way.
That's beautiful. We are going to get to talk more about that. Like Andile is saying, he loves his mistake, and I love my mistakes. I also love how I learn from my mistakes. Right about now, we are going to jump into a quick ad break, and then we are going to come back and get to have more in-depth conversation with Andile Kit Wakwalanga. Don't go anywhere. Please don't change that dial, because siyabuya ngoku. This is a takeover.
Abafana basenqushwa babinkomo zomfundisi.
Beautiful people, welcome back. You're still watching Hashtag Trending with me, Just Solomon. I am taking over the show, namhlanje, but I'm still joined with the wonderful Andile Kit Wakwalanga, who is going to be telling us more about ukubana ngaba ungubani yena. But now we are talking about how he got into this craft of interviewing abantu. Simazi ekholuku interview sha abanye abantu, but it's your turn now. It's your chance
weird.
Now. It's your chance
very
to shine.
Weird,
it's your chance to shine. So a little bit about Ilenduka, your love for broadcasting. How did you get into it, and what motivated you into getting into broadcasting?
So, put that on the tandu TED.
True that.
You know, and I remember back in the day, we used to watch EOTV a lot, me and Apiwe. And we'd sit there, you know, chigama chiga as well. We'll sit there and we'll imitate like the presenters and things like that. And I was like,
I think I want this.
I think I want to do this. And also, I think I like the fact that, you know, presenters are treated as the star of the show. So I was like, oh, okay. You know, all that peppering, you know, all that, the miking, you know, all of that. I was like, oh, this is pretty cute. Right? So I was like, I think I definitely want to do this. I didn't have any training. I didn't know anybody was a presenter that time. All I saw was how nice it is for people to do it on TV. And I was like, I want to do this.
Your first time of doing anything in the field was when?
When I started back in the day here, back when it was eBay TV, I started with a live show for 2 hours.
Ah.
And I was the only presenter.
Oh, man.
Kid you not. Mind you, I don't have any prior training. I've never presented before. I just came a week ago for my audition, and I did well in my audition. They called me back, and they were like, okay, we're going to do your screening. But we're going to do your screening on air, live, for a two-hour show. Big one up. I almost peed on myself. I almost peed on myself. And we were doing it outside studio, right?
Yeah.
We were doing it in the yard, but it was outside. 2 hours alone.
Must have been nerve-wracking.
Don't ask me what I said. Don't ask me how my links were. Don't ask me what my interviews were like. I don't remember. But the only thing I remember was 3, 2, 1, go. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. 1 minute remaining. 3, 2, 1, we out. Anything in between, don't ask me.
It is nerve-wracking. But also, I must commend you that you have done an incredible job. You know, you have done an incredible job, very inspiring job. And you have interviewed the most influential people. And in everything that you've done, interviewing those influential people, what are your top five most favorite times of interviewing those people? Who are your top five, by the way?
I'll speak in my career and I'll speak in this season,
yeah.
Right? In my career, I've interviewed a lot of South African A-listers. I've interviewed Prince KB, which is my favorite. He smells so good.
He'll definitely be your favorite.
Because I've interviewed, I think, like two, three times.
Yeah.
And I also interviewed Busiswa. Even when after she released the collab with Beyonce, amazing. I think those. And then with Hashtag Trending,
yes.
It was definitely Intombi Ramaphosa, Wendy. It was Ururisang Mohapi, who's on Gqeberha the Empire. It was Utafaya. I really enjoyed that. It was so much fun and funny. Number four would have been...
Me, I'm kidding.
You. No, I'm kidding. Number four would have been... No, let's do top three. Because number four would have been DJ Mbasa. I think DJ Mbasa, because also we went to watch her, you know, do what she does, which is DJing at Black Impala. That was
She's amazing,
so much
by the way.
She is fire. And the fifth one would be Ubablicious. Because also it was very much fun, you know, getting to know the world of, you know, that type of, you know, work.
Okay.
You know, sex work.
Professional sex work.
Yeah, professional sex. So those would have been my top five.
Mm. That's interesting. So for now, we are going to be taking it back to moments, right? I will also want you to give me your top five moments. But what we're definitely going to do is to just go to them, right? So just give me one before we go to it right now.
Definitely when Ubabli told me that she started with the dancing before she went on screen.
Cardi B vibes.
Basically, with the tattoos and everything. So definitely that is top two. Yeah.
Okay. With the top two, Bahlali Basekhaya, let's go and actually check it out. Mhlambe wena uyikhumbuli, but here it is right now.
Adult entertainment industry, I was up looking for a job as a waitress, you know. I just moved in for many radio station when I'm about, so things didn't go well.
Yeah.
And the other side, I lost my stepfather, who was a breadwinner. My mom was not working well. So my mom, I think, was a little bit depressed and endlini, like things became like challenging to an extent. Jonga ukhangela le dance dancing phansi kwebhedi and ngapha uyaphuma kwezinye inkqubo. So I was like, since ke mna ke nanithanda kwenza into zemodeling and I've always been independent udala naphanda kudala nami kwangumzomuri. So because bendisenza nee-magazines yabona promotion. So I was like, hey, come, let me humble myself and funum sebenze as a waitress.
Yeah.
The apply click club, country strip club, go to our arm and sissy. No, let's promote you into exotic dancing.
That's my own advantage.
Promote him, but man, we know finally. So that's.
Just like that, Mdasekhaya. Those were Andile's highlights of the previous season. Okwangoku, we want to know a little bit more about your highlights, Zaki, of, whoa, basically, what can we expect from season two? Then Chirukbananga, but this is a takeover. But get that, Kubana, we asked for a back. So what can people expect for season two?
Season 2 is going to be so much fun because the personalities that we're going to have on the show, very interesting, very refreshing. But also, we're going to have a lot of surprises, twists and turns with the set as well. You know, we're going to change a couple of things. Mm. But also, I think the imagery of season 2 is going to be very interesting. So you definitely don't want to miss that. But overall, it is going to be interestingly fun. Okay. That's for sure.
Lovely. So where can people get a hold of you? Maybe you are on any social media, yeah. Twitter, Instagram, and where?
TikTok, it is Andile Kitlanga. Facebook, Andile Kitlanga. Instagram, it is at Langa Andile. And on Twitter, yeah. It is at Andile _Langa. So if you just search Andile Langa all across social media, I should pop up.
And people can definitely go into his DMs.
Definitely go into... So, you know, unless you've got millions in your bank account, we can talk.
Okay, thank you so much, Andile Langa. Let's... A shake, I'm giving it back to you right now.
Thank you.
From me, thank you so much. My name is Josh Solomon, and I have done my bit of the shape of taking Ilonduga Show Yako. But right about now, please give us a closing link, Shanam.
This has been so much fun having my best friend of over 13 years doing the finale with. It is really, really heartwarming. Thank you so much for pulling through.
Thank you.
And for doing this with me. And to the team, thank you so much for this surprise, because I didn't know that this was happening. And it's secret eninazo. Until season 2, same time, same place. This has been so much fun. God bless you. Love and good night. Mashakanga Zichomi Tanga.